Ring for the Bride, but the.
Is it working? Yes. Hello, everybody. So, she's off in a few days, off to Kuwait. Economy class, one seat. Bit different to what he was going to buy. He was going to buy business class or first class, and he didn't get that, and he didn't even buy the economy class. She did. So, you know, desperate ways mean desperate measures or words to that effect. So, she's addressing me, I guess, when she's saying something like, his car, people are saying he's got plastic in the back seat. Well, yeah, I did say that. And he's not only been photographed in one car, he's been photographed in a few. So maybe he was just trying the suspension out, you know, because they're going to need pretty good suspension for a £500 heifer going. Sorry for people who don't like my language, but, you know, she's having digs at me, so I'll have a couple of digs back. And she's worth it, you know. So she's off in a few days. She's going to get married very shortly after they get there. Amy Ramadan went. She'd been speaking to Ali for months before she went over to, where was I? Cairo. She'd been speaking to him for months and FaceTiming him. And she went there, met his family, because they all lived in Cairo. That was his home. And I think it was Cairo. Don't shoot me down if it wasn't, but I think it was. And so his family lived there as well. So she met his family prior to their marriage. As Sala is a Syrian immigrant, a Syrian worker, Syrian worker status in Kuwait, I don't know whether his family are going to be there, any members of his family, so I don't know. She's buying the rings, which she said is custom. I don't know about that. I do know that at one time there was no wearing of rings, and then it changed, and the rings that they wore, they were going to be silver. So her thoughts of getting a great big lovely diamond ring might not be happening. I still think that he's an impoverished Syrian. I think that her ways of making money, she's taken a lot of videos down, put them into storage, she hasn't deleted them. And if she was genuine about becoming Muslim and marrying this man, all of her videos, her nasty videos, would have been deleted and there would have been a major change, but she's not done that. So what she's saying is after marriage, of course, they're going to be beezing together, and they've got plans to travel together and bees, and they're going to show lots of beautiful spots. Now, there's plenty of channels that are going to pick up on that, and I might do it as well and show some of what they're doing and comment on it, rather than watching every one of her videos all the way through. It's a pity that the farms are down again, I believe. I'll do a video on that, because I think the reason that they're down is the same reason that they were down before, and I don't agree with it. I don't agree with it. And I'll come on and I'll tell you why. So she's going off in a few days. What made me laugh in something I was just watching, he wants kids. Of course he does. Every Muslim man wants children, wants a family. And she can't give him kids. She's already said she's going to M-U-R-D-E-R a woman if he takes her as his second wife, when a short while back she was saying that she'd be agreeable to that. So now what she's saying is they'll get a surrogate. And she said, these are her words, I'm paraphrasing a bit, but basically she said, she used the word bank. She used the word purchase. So she's going to go to an egg bank she's going to purchase some eggs. And of course, they're going to find a surrogate. She's going to go to the egg bank. She's going to purchase the eggs. She is going to stipulate that she wants the donor of the eggs to have as many as her features, genetic features, as possible. So I guess that means the narrow palate, the baby teeth, you know, all the problems with the gums and the psychological problems. Maybe she wants somebody, egg donor, to be something like that. Heaven forbid. So she's going to go to the egg bank and purchase some eggs. That's further down the line. And of course, it will be Sellers' sperm that will be used to impregnate them, fertilise them in the donor, in the surrogate. So that's the plans. Off to Kuwait, a single seat. So I hope there's nobody either side. I believe that in the Cuba flight, I'm not sure whether it was a going or the coming back, there was a married couple, a young married couple sitting there, and she overspilled into the chair, and the newly married wife had to move away from her husband. How disgusting is that, really? Isn't it? They ought to have moved her and got somebody from the seat where the young lady was going to sit and got that person and the young lady sitting together and moved her in the corner somewhere. I remember a lot of things are coming back to me when I think about these things. I remember I was on a flight from Dharan to Riyadh, and was on this flight, and of course I was only wearing the abaya. My hair was long. I'll have to find out some photographs. My hair was really long, and I was sitting by this Arab gentleman. I think they were economy seats, the company bought them, and I was sitting by him, and he objected. He didn't want me sitting by him. He didn't want a woman sitting by him, a Western woman at that, without hair covered, and he complained. And what a treat that was, because they moved me, and they moved me up to business class, and it was lovely. I had champagne, so it worked out well for me. I don't think that's going to work out quite so well for Foodie, because if she's moved, it's going to be because of her girth. And people, Islami people, they are not backwards in coming forwards and saying exactly what it is that they're thinking. So that'll be interesting. So she's off in a few days. She's getting married a few days after that. I guess we'll get snippets here and snippets there to whet our appetite. As I say, it's a pity that the farms are down, because they've got over 6,500 pages right from the onset of her descent into this, what she's become now. 6,500 pages, and you know, I like to read them occasionally. So we'll see where it takes us. One more thing I want to address. She talking about the car, that he was just testing out the car, that he bought a car, but he kept the covers on the back. Two different cars, and he couldn't get your business car seat, and he's not paying for the rings. And he's not paying for the hotel. So she's paying for everything. And so that was the cars. That's what she nabbed me about. And the other thing, the pictures that she's posted of me smiling and showing my, laughing at my teeth. Well, let me tell you the story of my teeth. My teeth used to be absolutely beautiful. Again, I'll show you some pictures. When I was in Saudi, I had a broken jaw. We were playing a game where it was supposed to be softball, and somebody brought me down in a rugby tackle, and it hit the side of my face. And I went to the hospital, and they said I was just bruised. And I knew, because there was a clicking. And then they contacted me to say, you need to come because your jaw is broken. So I had to go into hospital, and my jaw was wired up for 6 weeks, during which time I couldn't eat. I remember I fancied baked beans the one day, and we liquidised baked beans. So disgusting. So that was the story with my jaw. I still have my teeth intact. And then for the osteoporosis I've got, I was on medication, and some of the medication I was on, somebody asked me in the comments a few videos back what medication I was on for osteoporosis, and I told them. And I said, beware, because the alendronic acid and the zoledronic acid medications, one of which was an infusion I had to go for, I think it was twice a year, and I was on it for 4 years. Or was it once a year? I can't remember. I was on it for 4 years anyway, and I'd had this broken jaw. I had a tooth that had had an abscess, so that had to be sorted out. And then they were feeding me this stuff into my system for my bones, and I never realised, I was never told, that if you've got problems in your mouth, it can badly affect, it can cause necrosis of the jaw, which means death of the jawbone, the gums. So it did cause me some problems. I did lose some teeth either side, and I am now, the others have sort of, because I've lost those teeth, they haven't got them, they're not propping my own teeth up. I've still got more teeth in my head than she has, but they're not propping my natural teeth up, and they're sort of bending a little. So anyway, I've had enough of it. I've had enough of the problems with my teeth. And I said about some months ago, when I next go to the dentist, I know he won't touch me, because if I have to have a tooth out, it could cause, because of the stuff I was on, has caused problems with my gums and my jawline. He won't touch me because it can cause excessive bleeding. So I have to go to the hospital or be in the hospital if I have a tooth out. So what I intended to do, and what is still in my mind to do, is to go, and I want the look of my own teeth back, right? So I'm prepared to lose what teeth I've got to get that back. And when I go to the hospital, I'm going to ask them, and I'm going to ask them if they can take these out, and then can I please have all on four implants into my jaw. I might not be able to because of the problems. I don't know what options are open to me, but that's the story of my jawline, my gums, and why that prat is posting photographs of me taken in the worst possible light. But, you know, I don't use filters, and she's got a photo, you know, my little profile picture that I've got, that clearly, you know, is one of those that's tarted up a bit. But I don't use filters on my videos, and what you see is what you get. So her digs at me are absolutely ridiculous. And it isn't that they bother me, it's just that I thought I'd address them because I think people might be interested to know the truth. So there's your truth. I will be back. I've got to make a very late breakfast here for people, and then get some cleaning done, and I may be back this evening. Depends what's going on. I'll speak to you all later. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.